Hi, welcome to a new tutorial. So what are modifiers? Assume that you have an object and you want to make some changes. In this case, it is a cube. You will be going to edit mode, right? Press tab and you can go to edit mode. You can select this vertex point and move that like that, for example. That is a change you have made to that corner. Or you can select other corner and move like that. And let me select this face, go to face select mode, select this face and extrude that region. Choose this extrude region option, or you can press E. Let me extrude like that, extrude again, extrude this up. So I'm basically modeling a new 3D model. So this is a way of creating your own 3D structures. So basically this is a destructive workflow. You are basically making a change to the object. So you may not be able to recover the initial object that you have started. So there is a way to create object through a non-destructive method. So those set of tools which will allow you to make non-destructive changes to an object is called modifiers. So you are basically modifying an object. Let me go to this menu called modifier properties, and you can see a drop-down menu here. All these options are different modifiers. If you add that to the object, it will create some changes. So here you can see array, which is for creating an array of object. You can see bevel, you can see boolean, skin, screw, remesh, solidify, skin. This array modifier will create an array of the object as the name suggests. So you can make all the changes in this modifier properties here, like count and direction of distribution like that. All these modifiers will have its own purposes, and it will have few settings associated with that, using which you can fine tune all the changes. So we are going to create a series. In one video, we will talk about one modifier. If you switch to playlist and you can see a playlist called modifiers, we will talk about one modifier at a time for scientific illustration needs. So we'll use very simple language to describe all these modifiers. So if you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. So using modifiers, you can actually do wonders. Like by adding multiple modifiers, you can create new effects. If I add subdivision surface modifier on top of this, you can see that it is getting subdivided like that. I can increase levels of subdivision. If I add displacement modifier on top of this, I can displace the geometry like this and choose a texture. You can see that displacement got distributed on entire array. And if I make some changes here in the displacement, it will be distributed on the entire distribution. How beautiful is that? So this is basically not changing the object as it is. So if you simply hide these modifiers, you can get your object back. How it will look like. You can simply close this modifier, so the object will retain as it is. So if you want to apply any modifier, assume that this is some kind of distribution that you wanted to create. This could be an array of some kind of nanomaterial. So you want this as a single object. You don't want this to be associated with any modifier. In that case, click on this drop-down menu on the top modifier here. It is array now. And click apply. Now that array modifier is applied. Now you won't be able to make any changes on that array modifier. Now click on this drop down menu for subdivision surface modifier. Click apply. And for displace, click apply again. Now this is a single object. We have applied all the changes that we created using set of modifiers on that object. Now this is an object. You won't be able to make any changes from now. Make sure that you have the object as you want, then apply the modifiers if it is needed. You may not want to apply the modifiers all the time. So in this series, we will talk about one modifier at a time. We will talk about the very basics of the modifier, how we can use that and what is the idea behind. If you switch to the playlist, you can see all the modifiers named. I will add one by one over time. If you have any specific questions, let me know in the comment section. I will answer that. If it need a separate tutorial, I'll create a tutorial for you.